More twists and turns in the alleged cover-up in a massive drug bust in Manila last year, uncovered by a House panel. Now, in their latest hearing, lawmakers learned that a different police officer arrested Master Sergeant Rodolfo Mayo, and not the officers who were first reported to have apprehended the alleged narco cop. Now, for more on their inquiry, we are now joined by Antipolo Representative and retired police official Romeo Acop. Good noon, Representative Acop, and welcome to Dateline Philippines.
Yeah, hello. Stanley. Hello.
Yes, welcome, sir.
Yeah, Stanley, good afternoon. At good afternoon din sa mga tagapakinig po ninyo.
All right, magandang hapon din po. Representative Acop, you said or described the messy operation of the Philippine National Police as behind the fact that there could be a weak case against Master Sergeant Rodolfo Mayo in relation, of course, to the 6.7 billion shabu haul last year. Let's go through your impressions first. Ano po ba yung findings ninyo as you conducted a probe on this?
Yeah, in the last hearing that we conducted, it seems that the PNP officers and members were involved in the 990 kilos illegal drug haul. I think came up with a script that is farthest from the truth.
Okay, and that script, of course, involved some inconsistencies, discrepancies dun sa sinasabi ninyong arresting officers. Can you expound on that?
Yeah, Stanley, it was very clear in that last hearing that we had that there were reports submitted to higher authorities and I think in to the courts also na hindi totoo.
Hindi po totoo yung
ano po?
Hindi po totoo yung alin po?
Yung pong ang pagka-aresto ni Mayo officially,
okay,
officially as reported was done in the morning at around 2:30 in the morning of October 9.
Okay.
If you look at the records.
Okay.
But the CCTV footage would show that at 1 o'clock in the afternoon of October 8, Mayo was already under the custody of these police officers.
Okay. Okay, now one of the discrepancies that you pointed out is iba po yung arresting officers kaysa dun sa mga officers na in charge dun sa operation. Now, Representative Acop, how normal is it for a different set of police officers to file the case as against those that are really involved in the operation?
You must remember, Stanley, na if you are the arresting officer, you will come out with an affidavit of arrest,
okay,
which would be submitted to the prosecutor and to the courts.
Okay.
Ngayon, kung matuloy yung kaso, let's say for example, ilagay sa witness stand yung police officer na nag-execute ng affidavit of arrest at tatanungin ng abogado ng defense, paano mo inaresto si Mayo?
Okay.
Ay, hindi niya masasagot ng tama yon dahil hindi naman siya talaga ang nag-aresto kay Mayo eh.
Okay. Now, aside from that, Representative Acop, what other inconsistencies do you find in your own probe?
Yun lang ang na-discover ko noong last hearing. But apparently, may ang nangyayari is talagang two things. Number one, they're trying to protect Mayo.
Okay.
We don't know the reason why.
Okay.
Number two, yung bang pagpasok nila sa WPL lending, cover up nila eh, dahil sabi nila it's a follow-up operation.
Mm.
No, tinanong ko ngayon kwan eh, ano pa yung crime na final nyo kay Sergeant Mayo.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi I find it surprising na ang nag-file sa kay Ney Atadero ay yung team ni Susongko.
Okay.
Tapos itong kay Mayo, ibang official si Captain Pinyon and his team. So, isa lang naman yung kwan sa CCTV eh. Doon si Atadero, nandun si Mayo. So, at sinabi ng team ni Captain Pinyon na they arrive at the scene 4 o'clock, ang sabi ni Juan, ni Pinyon.
Mm-hmm.
Eh sabi naman nung team member niya, 10 o'clock.
Okay.
So, hindi mo malaman ngayon, assuming na yung pinakamaaga, 4 o'clock ang dating nila, eh how could they explain na si Mayo was already in the custody of Susongko's team ng 1 o'clock.
Okay, now Representative Acop, what explanation did the police officers offer as to this discrepancy?
Ah, hindi na sila sumagot. The officers who allegedly arrested Sergeant Mayo requested for an executive hearing. And Stanley, I cannot reveal yung data na nakuha namin doon sa executive hearing.
Okay. Of course, all of these investigations, Representative Acop, brought to light many of the issues hounding our drug campaign. We, of course, saw that it brought to light yung recycling ng illegal drugs na nako-confiscate. How prevalent is this practice, even during your time?
Nung time po kasi namin is kwan eh. Mm-hmm. Nawala yung list ng Narcotics Command in 1991 when the PNP was created. We were there. Inalis yung Narcotics Command by law, Republic Act 6975. Mm-hmm. Therefore, ang mga yung Narcotics Command ng PNP na abolish. Mm-hmm. We were not told to operate against illegal drugs. It was PDEA then. PDEA was created also to take care of the illegal drugs problem.
Okay.
Anong po yan? Mm-hmm. Somewhere along the line, merong chief PNP because he's authorized by law to create operational support units. So, nag-create sila uri ng HSOT, Anti-Illegal Drug Special Task Force, which was turned into yung AIDG, Anti-Illegal Drug Group. Doon yung nangyari na naman, yung namatay si Ikju, yung Korean, sa loob ng Camp Rame. At ang mga pumatay na nadimanda ay taga AIDG.
Okay, it seems that Master Sergeant Mayo is getting some support here. Would you venture as to who is giving him protection?
Eh, di syempre yung unang-una yung team leader niya, si Colonel Ibanez.
Okay.
Now, as to who is protecting Colonel Ibanez, maybe the PNP can determine that how come na si Colonel Ibanez at saka si Mayo were in the drug list of then President Duterte, bakit sila nakabalik sa PDEC?
Okay. Now, Representative Acop, you also brought up an interesting point about illegal drugs, our problem with it as far as how involved some of our law enforcers are in the operation. You're saying umabot na sa third level police yung operation on drugs and that what they have done here, they could do also to ordinary people. Can you expound on this?
I am also investigating yung anti-illegal drug bust by bust committed by police officers in Region 4A.
Okay.
But it is being heard by the Committee on Public Order and Safety. nakikita ko na doon sa ibaba, sa ground, ay ganun din ang modus operandi. Yung illegal drug bypass nila, I say it's illegal simply because they're committing crimes to come up with anti-illegal drug accomplishments. For example, meron silang suspect na tao, ina-abduct nila yung tao at sinasabi, bypass operation ang kwan, kaya siya nahuli. We are investigating that sa region, sa Committee on Public Order and Safety. Okay. These are policemen na nandun sa field. Ang team leader nila in major.
Okay.
Ngayon, dito sa taas, ito ang iniimbestigan namin sa Committee on Dangerous Drugs, ay yung mas malaki na haul.
Okay.
So, may problema tayo.
Okay. Now, given the magnitude of this problem, as you implied it, that it is happening not just in the upper levels but in the low levels, how accurate now is our figures as to the achievements of our anti-illegal drug campaign?
This is my personal opinion, Stanley. May mga... Kasi the question is, how did the... Sergeant Mayo accumulate 1 ton of illegal sugar.
Okay.
Diba?
Okay.
So, tinignan ko yung operations ng Juan from 2021 to 2022, end of 2022. Yung operations na kinondak ng team ni Colonel Ibanez. Kasi, tinitignan ko doon yung mga nahuhuli nila na Juan. Nandun yung kwan 60 kilograms of shabu, 60 kilograms of shabu, 10 kilograms of shabu. Baka sa aking teorya lang, Sandy, baka nag-saving sila Savings in the sense na 400 kilograms ang nahuli, ang i-re-report mo, 60 kilograms.
Okay.
Yun, ganun ang
So parang sinasabi, niyo they deliberately understate the amount, no, or the quantity that they have retrieved. For what purpose, though?
Nakita niyo naman doon sa kwan, si Sergeant Mayo na nagbebenta.
Okay, so purely...
You could just imagine yung amount, kwan, Stanley. 2 kilos would amount to 13 plus million.
Okay, so clearly this is a recycling story, a recycling,
yes,
of shabu, which of course led to a lot of developments, including the investigation on top-ranking police officials and their involvement in illegal drugs. And of late, we have the five-man panel reporting to us that they are now investigating, or in fact, mulling charges on 4 police officials out of the 900 plus that they have sought courtesy resignations from. What is your reaction to this?
Stanley, they should do it fast.
Okay.
Kasi hindi lang dapat dyan sa level na yan sila dapat maghanap kung sino yung mga involved sa illegal drugs.
Okay.
They should go down to the level of those officers assigned in the field.
Okay. Okay, and do you believe it's just 4 in that level? Apat lang ba talaga? Apat lang ba talaga?
I was informed na 32 yan. Oo, pero sabi nila yung talagang pinakagrabe at pinakamataas, yung 4.
Okay, but the mataas does not mean the others are less guilty, though.
No. ito lang siguro yung nakitaan ng yung five-man panel,
okay,
na talagang substantial yung evidence that are against them.
All right. Lastly, Representative Acop, the House probe, what can you tell us about it? What direction are you headed, and what are the goals of the probe? When can we expect findings and results and an official impression?
The the committee report would contain pretty much the result of our investigation based on the statements and the pieces of evidence that we have gathered from the persons or from our resource persons insofar as the inquiry in aid of legislation is concerned. I think that the NAPOLCO and the hierarchy of the PNP should seriously look into this. Kasi I asked them, ano po ang tingin ninyo dyan sa opisina nyo na nag-operate against illegal drugs? Kasi walang, ang nangyari sa yung controversy, para bang hinahound yung unit na yun. So I asked them, are you thinking of abolishing the anti-drug unit, anti-illegal drug unit of the PNP? Mm-hmm. Sabi po naman nila, pag-iisipan nila. So it's up to them, but we will make our own recommendations based on the hearings that we have conducted, Stanley.
All right, and we do look forward to those recommendations and a resolution to a lot of issues hounding law enforcement and the illegal drug campaign. Again, Representative Romeo Acop, thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. Magandang hapon po.
The pleasure is mine, Stanley. Magandang hapon din po sa inyo.